Hello guys, welcome back to another video on my channel. If you happen to be new around here, hello, my name is Dharma. I'm a Roblox YouTuber and I love to do this type of things, and I also like to do other artsy stuff on here, so if you want to, go ahead, hit the subscribe button, and join the Dharma family. Secondly, I'm finally going to finish the starter house. You know, the starter house renovation. There's some projects that I just simply gave up on. But this one? No, I'm finishing it today. There's no more dilly-dally wasting time. I'm going to finish. I'm going to be finishing projects that are in progress. For this one, I only finished one room. I don't have the whole entire process of building. Time for the tour. Woohoo! Let's start it. The garden. This door is automatic. Here, oh, I got the automatic sensor. Let's go to build mode. Okay, so this is a block book item, but it's only 25. And if you log in for 5 days in Bloxburg, you get 40 block books. I put it in two places in the house. Placed it in the front of the house, but I wanted to be extra. You enter. I put a painting right in the very entrance over there on the shelf. I put plants over there on the shelf. I really love those plants. I put a little triangular pyramid right there. I put a quote. It says, prove them wrong. Sometimes we just think that we can't prove people wrong. And sometimes we have to be reminded, hey, we can prove people wrong. And we can do what we're gonna do without them stopping us and telling us that we can't do. Because we're capable of doing anything that we achieve our mind to. And all of these are boxes. I colored the bottom a darker shade to make it look like shoes. Right, and the up shelf, I put a light box. Put the string lights up right onto the dining room. Added a clock. I'll put this beautiful hanging light. Here's the landscape. Put some plating placing mat. So the color scheme that I went with is dirt brown, dark stone gray, and sandy blue. Very bright white. I put carpet on top of carpet. I left this picture as is. Resemble that somebody lives here. A little reindeer. A plant. Now, if you're wondering why do the walls have borders, these are called wall trim. I put a half wall trim. I also put pillars in the very corner. I put the top border. I put different borders depending on the room I was doing. Go to build and then you find wall trim. Why does this happen every time? The next place that I'm going to show you is the living room. So I made the walkthrough right here a lot more convenient since over there there's stuff on the wall. I ended up adding a couch. What type of texture did I use? I used furry carpet. I used a modern type of table. Made it into different sections. Paper, a plant, a mug, and a flashlight. Over there, I put a new decoration, a plant. There is a quote. It says, love yourself. I feel like it's very important. I put the lamps over here that, surprisingly, this time match with the ceiling lamp. Hello. The shelf looks like roof because I was trying to go back to the original design I had from the bedroom to go and do it throughout the house. Crush text. A stack of cards. I put books to fill up the space, a globe, two picture frames. They're just pictures of landscapes. Another succulent. I have another. The right wall, we have a bookshelf. Lots of books to cover up the space. A plant. And then I have a llama. Bathroom. The bathroom door is already open because I put an automatic sensor door. Yeah, I wouldn't really necessarily recommend to put the automatic sensor thing near rooms that you're really going to be near. I put a mirror. I just felt like it looked really nice. But a trash can. I have a tip. I don't know why, but I've been seeing builders, they seem to forget a trash can. We use the bathroom, we need a trash can. We use the kitchen, we need a trash can. Bedroom, sleeping, crafting, gaming, all these other things, we need a trash can. But people forget to add that in, which is concerning. If you're making a build, it should at least look at least a little realistic. I went with a wooden plank, light white for the walls, plants that I felt like it went really well with the rest of the house, backlit mirror, regular sink that you can find, toothbrush. I put tables, okay? And I put the smallest table, then I put a bigger table, and then that's how I made it steps. I colored it to make it kind of look like steps. Then, you're in the shower! You go into the shelf, and then there's plant, candle, and soap. It looks like a box. It is a box, but I made it look like soap and think of it as a huge bar of soap. Okay, up here is perfumes, lotion, and all the things that you need for your daily skin routine. And then you have like plants, and that's a comb, but you can't really see it, so I have to like jump, and you can see it for a split of a second. I added a shower head into this tub to make it more realistic, as usually how bathtubs, bathrooms are. Sometimes there's a standing shower, sometimes there's a bathtub with a shower head, and I decided to put that into the build. The walls over here in this area of the bathroom is dirt brown. Like I said, I wanted to go with the dirt brown and the rest of the colors, which is sandy blue, light white, which is right next to the bright white. That's the only thing I could like describe right now. And I ended up putting, I ended up putting a traditional door frame. Then I put a curtain, kind of blending it with the color of the wall, but kind of making it look like more of a warm, relaxing area, not open and like here I am type of area because of the bathroom. Yeah, that's it for the bathroom. I'm going to show you the kitchen, and then for lastly, I'm going to show you the bedroom that I had built months ago. Stairs as a decoration, pots and plants, put a lamp, kind of making it like warm lighting because it's a kitchen. I feel like it should also be relaxing. We have a small mug, a short glass, and a tall glass, and I feel like the small mug would go with the coffee. The short glass would go with tea. I mean, it can go with the mug too, but I don't know, it just felt like it made sense. And then the tall glass would go with smoothies, obviously, because smoothies usually have tall glasses. I put a cutting board, and then I put ice over here. Hello, human! Hello, how's it hanging, neighbor? There's a toaster, a small pot, a fryer. I don't know why I added a fryer. Maybe just because I was running out of ideas and decorations. But a fryer, you still use it, like, for donuts. So, come on, if you want to bake some donuts and have a fryer in the kitchen. I did. I like donuts. The dishwasher, because it's one of the new items that Bloxburg has added recently. I put a paper towel, because we're gonna need paper towels. Ended up adding a cup of spatulas, a big pot, a plant, spices over here. I added the sink, and then a bar of soap. I could have done a bottle of soap, not a bar of soap, but I wanted to do a bar of soap for some reason. But something, I will give you a little bit of history lesson. This over here in the corner is called a mocha head. It's where you put fruit or vegetables, and you take this part and you smash your fruits or your vegetables. This is like something that I don't know if it's still used. I'm pretty sure some people still use it, but most people now rely on the blender now because it's not what we use current day. But before the blender, we used this from my side of the family. We have a ketchup bottle, a mustard bottle, a hot sauce bottle, a syrup bottle because we need some pancakes with syrup. I ended up putting a bowl, a stack of plates with what color? Sandy blue. That's right. Good job. Give yourself a pat on the back. This right here, I put a fork and a spoon. It's just little details that make things a lot better. So yeah, that's the rest for the kitchen. For the switches, I turn it off, right? But this switch connects to the living room. Okay, you're like, okay, fine, maybe it just connects the living room all the way through the hallway and in the entrance. Not exactly. You see, if I click this and I go back, everything turns off. Why? Because if you use the wall trims and you put light switch on the wall trims, or just even on one wall trim, it turns off every wall trim or every room that used the wall trim of the lights of that room off. So I use stairs, like I said. And what I used for the kitchen build over there. So, I went with like kind of like a tropical type of scenario. I went with a light green. I still ended up liking the whole entire thing. But the thing is, I used green in this. And then everything else like sandy blue, dark gray. And I'm like, it's different. I feel like the bedroom is a completely different paradise versus everything else. I added a light over here. I ended up adding these modern windows, which I used in the living room as well. I put this painting, which is the original type of painting design that you get when you place it. And I ended up putting a darker outline to kind of pop from the color of the wall because it's so bright. I ended up using the same type of color scheme. Hey, way to go past me. I ended up adding a window. It used to be a butterfly, but here's what seems really funny to me. I used a pine tree, right? You can kind of see that. Okay. And I ended up building a pine tree look on the window. Different type of lights over here. I'm not sure why I did that. I added a light box for decoration, an alarm, adding seats. I added the large dresser. I also added carpet. So for the outside, I used a dark stone gray and a very light white as planked type of house. And then I used a modern roof. So I don't really know what style I was going with, but in the end, I really liked the result. Also, I really hope that you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to tap the like button, tap the subscribe button, and click that little bell notification so you never miss an upload. I hope you have a terrific Tuesday, and as I always say, be you, stay sweet, and don't forget to be kind. I will see you right after this video because I'm going to put in another video. Stay tuned. Bye!